Hello, 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 and welcome to Illusion Fox Gaming. So today we are doing this is what, week three of Season of Plunder? Yeah, week three. I'll take a look at this because Iron Banner is going on here right now. I want to have some more fun with this.
New readings. Baroness's fleet moves across the system, pursuing relics of power. Summon your crew. And a request, please. As a favor to me. Do not involve Ido in your violence against the old crews. She is brave and curious, but does not yet understand the brutality of the world. There are pain truths in our history. I should have told her earlier, before all this. But I must learn before I can teach, and for that I need time. Disrupt Aramis's crews, and stop her from collecting the relics. Some mistakes must remain in the past.
No, that's the wrong one. This is what I wanted. I wanted to go here. So I need to just choose the expedition from here? No, because of course not. Meaning I gotta get lucky and actually have the right one pop up when I queue in. Oh, let's see here. So I figure if it's saying defeat combatants on Nessus, that's where. Oh, look, I think we got the one we wanted in the first place. Awesome! I like it when that happens.
Got a good tip on some loot buried around here. Let's secure the dig site.
Our drill will attract attention. Be ready for battle.
Calm your mandibles. We got a hero of the Vanguard here to protect us.
Fuck the Vanguard. What the fuck? Oh yeah, I said the single shot. Give me that special ammo.
Fight.
I don't know what cabal he was talking about, but. Ah, oh, damn it. Yeah, it was worth a shot. It really was, at least to me. It did work out, but it was worth it.
Got what we came for. Let's get off this cubic hellhole.
So soon? Oh, I was hoping to tour the Exodus Black. A vintage AI like Failsafe must be a treasure trove of Golden Age information.
I guess, but talking to Failsafe is like teaching a thrall to play harmonica. More trouble than it's worth.
Maybe. Let's see here. Now I need to go do this. Excuse me. I'm wearing the best stuff I got.
You become quite adept at bringing down these pirate lords. Do you think the rest are terrified?
No.
Here, you'll face Ta'ol and Tha'ur with four cleavers between them. A strong arm and a sharp edge. They always think that's the only thing they need.
Your cover didn't help you.
Those cleavers. We don't want to tire out your ghost.
Actually, just because. That was a lot shorter, I felt like, than...
Mizrax hasn't told you any more about these relics, has he? I suppose it's need to know. And Mizrax knows.
Spider, why are you using a secure channel? Did my father tell you to do so?
Huh? Clever scribe. No more flattery? Well, Mizrax asked me to keep you at arm's length. Perhaps he doesn't want you mixing in with our unsavory business.
Were those his exact words?
Only a guess. Who can say? And after all, who am I to question the Kelm?
Spider? I will find out what's going on here.
She's a nosy one, isn't she? I mean, who can blame her, though? Let's go witness this conversation, this particular conversation. So that must be the three dig sites.
Baron Spider, I greet you in the light.
Baron? I haven't heard that in some time. What is it you want?
You have a great interest in human cultures, and as such, have acquired many curiosities.
Yes, I had quite the collection before my unfortunate relocation. reason why you failed me. Get to the point.
I have a question.
Of course you do.
You and my father came from the House of Wolves, once known as the House of Gentle Weavers. I have very little record of that time. A first-hand account would be invaluable.
Kel wouldn't like my speaking to you.
Mees Rex Kel would understand. This is important to the history of House Light, of which you are a part.
You don't know what your father is capable of, little scribe.
What does that mean?
This conversation never happened.
That went rather poorly.
Yeah, that did.
Spider, there are questions my father refuses to answer. Have you seen him act this way before? You two were friends once.
Even if Mees Rex had friends back then, I wasn't among them. I couldn't possibly speak to his behavior.
You're being evasive.
That's all Spider does.
I prefer to think of it as coy. Well then, your father was unpredictable. We could have had everything we wanted if he listened to me, but he always knew better. And look at him now. Caliver House, holed up inside the city. Picking over ruins, pretending he's content in the shadow of the great machine.
We were offered scraps and we took them.
Oh. Is that ingratitude, I hear?
I do not call the truth ingratitude, but enough of who my father is. Who was he?
Ah!
I expected this from Spider, but not from you.
I am simply performing my duties as scribe of House Light. I will gather knowledge regardless of who would keep it from me.
Ruckus. I told you not to speak of this. Do I have to dock your tongue?
Father! I apologize for the Kel's behavior.
Apology accepted. I see now. You're afraid little Ido will take off those rose-colored glasses. Such a delightful human phrase. And what will she see when she looks at you then? Do not speak to my daughter again. Oh, don't worry about me. Though, I'm not the only one who remembers. Sooner or later, she'll learn the truth.
Which but could I'm be bad.
Sure it will all work out. After all, what is it you say? The light provides.
This still very much feels like a anime filler season. But we're starting to see some division between things.
Hey there, Captain. Figured I'd better take over while Mithrax is preoccupied. I heard he's dealing with some family issues. From what I could gather, he tried to shut Ido out from all this pirate business. Might have lost his temper. Definitely lost face. Poor Ido. What do they say? Never meet your heroes? Kinda tough when your hero's your dad.
But that's actually fairly common.
No surprise to me, Mithrax has got some secrets. Everybody's got something that keeps him up at night. I'm sure they'll work it out. Folks have a way of putting aside their differences when the world's at stake. Just look at me and Zavala. Or me and Ikora. Or me and... anybody, really.
Yeah, you're not the friendliest of people.
for a favor.
We'll roll a die. 16. You look up from your pitiful winnings and notice Spider is barely paying attention to the Ingrams. Bad luck again, he mumbles. That's a real shame, Guardian. But I suppose we all have cold streaks from time to time. He straightens up in his chair. Give me a while to restock, he says. I'll let you know when I have new Ingrams to distribute. He fixes you with a condescending smile. I'm sure you'll win next time. Ida's voice comes in over your radio. More energy interference, he cries. That was the last piece of triangulation data I required. I believe I figured out a way to block these energy spikes. Should another one occur. You seem to be the catalyst, he tells you. Thus, I will trigger my suppression field the next time Spider asks you to pay him a social call. Perhaps we will be able to figure out this puzzle together.
It's been a pleasure doing business with you.
We'll go back here in a moment and see if I must have broken it somehow, I guess. I don't know. Must have gotten last week's radio message, I guess.
I've been trying to determine what exactly is inside these reliquaries, but I dare not open them. The resulting surge of darkness energies would have unforeseeable effects on my physiology. However, I did manage to secure a centuries-old Vanguard mission report from the Cryptarchy. The reporting Guardian said that Elixni crews were infighting over what he called, quote, chunks of rotting meat. The report is of dubious quality, but it did make me wonder if the relic could be biological in nature.
I mean, I don't see why not. Okay, let's check the radio again and see if it'll give me my... my recording or not. I don't like the stats on it. There we go.
I kept this part quiet. I think half of those pirate lords didn't know what they had to begin with. They knew these things were powerful, but not why. Crack one open and you'd find a finger bone or a knot of old hair. Strong stuff. Smells awful. Ask me how I know. I've been holding on to them, but I figured you might want them.
Why?
I thought to myself, you know who might like something strange and unsettling? Eris Morn.
A gift, then?
Well, yeah, Moondust. You could call it a gift.
The sentiment is appreciated. But no. You know what you possess. These relics are not simple curiosities to be hoarded. They might serve a greater purpose.
And what's that?
Am I your conscience? Discover this for yourself. They are reliquaries, objects of great power. The darkness moves just beneath its skin. Do you feel it? It ruptures, flows, envelops.
Ooh, I like listening to you talk.
And I enjoy your silence.
Okay. Conversation with Neris Morn and but that was week 3 of Season of Plunder. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and hopefully we'll see you again either at another live stream over on Twitch, where we stream daily from 12 a.m. to at least 3 a.m. or later, or maybe you'll come by and watch another video here on YouTube. But till then, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your evening.